Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today, with kind of a different episode as usual. Today's about this twisty puzzle here. It's called the Afterlife Cube and is part of a campaign that's currently live on Kickstarter. It was just launched a few days ago, and this cube is actually a very, very early prototype, or let's say kind of a proof of concept. You might notice it does not look like a serial production product. This is really entirely made out of printed parts and some prototype electronics to prove that the concept is actually working. And what's interesting on this concept is it basically looks like a standard twisty puzzle, a 3x3x3 cube, but it is actually working entirely different. To turn this cube on, we will just twist one face and we can see that some of the tiles will light up, in this case in a blue color. Now it should be better visible. You can see that three of the tiles are now lit. And this already gives us some information because the target is actually to make this entire cube light up in blue color. Right now there are only three faces. You might also notice here that some of the faces are slightly blinking. But as I mentioned, this is only a very, very early concept, different from other Kickstarter campaigns, not pre-developed and ready to be launched or something. This is a real crowdfunding project. And now let's look a bit here how this generally works, that you can understand how to solve it. So these three tiles are now, as I mentioned earlier, light up in blue. And I need to get the entire cube in blue color. If I start twisting the sides, for example, other tiles will light up. And you might also notice that they light sometimes up in different colors. And this is again because this cube is the only prototype that can reproduce all three game modes. For now, in this episode, we're only focusing here on the standard game mode. We will also have another episode coming up. And there I discuss more in detail about this game mode, about the technical concept of this cube and also the other game modes with two team members of the invented team. But how does this cube work and what is actually the task and how to solve it? I will for sure not be able to solve it here entirely in this video, but let me try to solve one phase of this cube or explain you what need to be done. As I mentioned, three tiles are now light up, and if I twist it, other tiles start to light up. So you can see here, ignore these colored areas as I said. You can see here that different areas are light up, and the target of this blue gaming mode is to get all the tiles on the right surface, and if you do so, they will light up in blue. So this corner piece giving us now the information, for example, that this face here of the corner piece is on the right surface, but these two here are actually not, okay? So for example, if I twist it further, like so, this one will light up. Okay, so this means now this one is also on the right surface, and this makes this one very interesting. I need to remember pieces that turn off if I'm turning it off the right surface. So for example, I turn this one down. This one is in the right surface. The other one is now down here. If I now replace this one with the previous one and turn it back, I got both of them in the right surface, but still they are only the right surface. They are not in the right corner at this point because these are still not light up in blue. Okay. So I will proceed like this now to try to finish one complete or entire surface here. And to do that, I will just turn this around and see what other tiles are lighting up if I put them here. Okay. So I got this one here. I got this one here. So I will just try to get both of them here. Or let's, no, you know what? I will use a different tactic. I will try to make the first the cross, same as the white cross you usually do on a regular cube. Got this one, and now let's see if I find also the other piece here of this cross. Here we go. Now I got one cross, and now I will look for the corner pieces. So the cross is here. Here we got one corner piece. And here we got the cross. So I need to turn this one around, it seems. Yeah. I need to bring it up here. Here we go. One more. Here we go. Got another one. It's gonna be easy. Here we go, and only one is missing now. This one right here. Here it is. It's gonna be also an easy one. Oh, I removed also this one now. Here it is. Now it's easier. So here we go. One side is entirely in blue, blinking a bit sometimes in green. Yes, but as I said, this is a very, very early prototype. And the contacts are having maybe, or the electronics maybe are not in contact properly, or maybe slightly contaminated from the dust of the printed parts. However, this is how you solve this cube. And you saw already how much I struggled on a regular cube. I can do this quite quick, yeah, finish one side. This is no problem at all. But on this one, I really need to think in a different way, because you need to remember the tiles that go off, arrange them again in the right way. So it definitely helps knowing how to solve a regular cube, but knowing how to solve a regular one is definitely not everything to solve this one. So this is an entirely new playing concept, and you can see already here that one surface is now solved correctly, but the other surface here, the other surfaces are all not correct. I do so. I will also remove the corner. Ooh, and you can see already how much I struggle to finish the second surface. This is actually really great. So to every one of you who are very familiar with other cubes, I can highly recommend this one, because you will learn much more about how to exchange pieces. Now, for example, if you need to exchange a certain piece at a certain position with another one, and you want to have it in that position with an orientation, to me, this is actually too tricky. I have no idea. I don't know the algorithms how to do that. But if you are interested to improve your skills in doing this, this is the tool you need. Yeah. Okay, I will work on this a bit more. Yeah, I'm very much convinced of this project, and I really would like to see this getting realized. I decided to do two videos. Okay, so today's video was to demonstrate you a bit here this cube, how it works. You can now think about if you like this product, if you like it. As I said, I put your link in the description where you can help funding this project. Your support is greatly appreciated, of course. I decided to record another video with two guys of the Inventor team to explain us a bit more details about this project, how they came up with the idea, maybe also dive a bit deeper here into the technology they used to realize this. And this video will be released in a few weeks, so be sure to check it out if you would like to learn more about this awesome and unique puzzle you've seen today. If you have any comments about this product, about this video, or any ideas maybe how to improve it, any questions, comment below this video. I'm sure the Inventor team is more than happy to read your comments and also to answer them. That's it for today, and until next time, keep on puzzling.